applications. Website means web applications. Web applications means we can access through the web using internet access through the browser. Browser means what are the things we'll call it as browser? Chrome is one browser, okay, and Internet Explorer is one browser, Firefox is one browser. If you are familiar with Mac, Safari is the browser, and Opera, these are the major browsers. If you have a internet, through internet, if you can access any of the website, that is called as web applications. For example, here if I type Google, means I can access the Google through this web, means it is a web applications. If you want to develop the web applications, means we need to design the pages, web pages. Here Google means, here whatever you are saying, Google one test box. This is UI, generally. Any website, this is it. If you want to develop any web applications, web application means that will run on the web. It will, generally it will run on the some web servers using this username, the host name and port number will access. But on top of that, directly providing the host name, they will register with the domain names, that is called as www.google.com. Here, if you are developing any website, means that user interface, these are called as user interface. User can interact it. Why they are calling as user interface means, for example, here, I'm the user, I can give some text, like HTML. If I give HTML, it will give some results. So I'm interacting with this website, I'm getting the results. That's why user interactions, user interface. So to develop the pages, the basic things we required is HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML, CSS, JavaScript. First things. Here, HTML means it will provide the tags, means it will provide the default. Well, if you want to present some text box or anything in the browser, means we can using this HTML, we can develop this text box. But here, Google was there in different colors, like red, green, and if you want to, in HTML, the font is Courier and all the default color is black. But here it was represented in blue color, red color and green color and so many. If you want to apply those colorings, we can use the CSS. That is called Cascade Styling Sheet. You can add the colors, fontings, paddings, background images. These all kind of styles. Sorry? Hello? Is it someone is asking something?
Hello, Karen, Karen. Go ahead.
Here, HTML.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, okay. Thank you. HTML means it will provide this text box and it's black color, default fonts. But here, Google was designed in blue and red and green. These kind of styles we can apply through the CSS. Okay. And also here, whatever you are typed here, HTML. Okay, HTML, and if you click on the search button, means after click on the search button, it will do some kind of validations. Those kind of validations we are going to do with the okay, these three are the minimum technology, or we can say it is a base for to learn the UI technologies. And apart from this, what is jQuery and what is AngularJS means? jQuery is the one of the framework for the JavaScript. We need to write a lot of code. That's why it was eliminated. And also it has provided some feature like cross browser issues. Those kind of issues it was solved in the jQuery. So, but still it is developed on top of JavaScript only, jQuery also. Like who are all knows about the Java, they knows the some of the frameworks like Spring, Hibernate. Even these are Spring and Hibernate are different frameworks, still we require the core Java. Like this here, jQuery is also one of the framework, but it's totally written on the JavaScript. To learn the jQuery or AngularJS, these three technologies are must: HTML, CSS, JavaScript. These three are very much to learn all these three technologies. So on top of that, there are some advantages and disadvantages in the jQuery. jQuery was that they are going to write in the single files. So AngularJS came into the market. It was divided client side code into the MVC layer. MVC is the one of the design pattern. They divided into the MVC design pattern. The whole code was divided into the modules: model, view, and controller. Okay, here nowadays any websites, you can see this. If you open any bank website, that should work. That should work in the tab. That should work in the computer. Nowadays, this is must and should. So that's why the Liquid UI is came into the market. Liquid UI means, for example, if you take the water and if you pour into the glass, get this that shape. And if you pour into some vessel, it will get that shape. That's why here Liquid UI means, if you develop one website, that website, if you open in the tab, it will fit for this tab. If you open in the computer, it will fit for that computer. If you open in the smartphone, it will fit for that. That kind of design is required. That's why Bootstrap is came into the picture. Bootstrap will provide this Liquid UI kind of stuff. But how to use that, we are going to learn in the course. So this is about the whole thing. In this course, we are going to cover almost HTML, CSS, JavaScript. jQuery, I will cover 60 to 70%, and Bootstrap and AngularJS 100%. But only jQuery, I will not cover full things. I will cover almost 80 to 90%. But plugin development I want to cover, because nowadays no one is using the jQuery, but some of the legacy projects still they are using the jQuery. And apart from this, we are going to discuss the AJAX calls for asynchronous requests and JSON. I'm going to tell you in this course JSON and as well as AJAX. So I'm going to tell you that what is the course content we are going to cover in this course. It will take totally 20 to 25 classes. That means 20 to 25 hours. Daily I will take 1 hour class. It will take 20 to 25 hours. Okay, every day I'm going to tell you one topic. I'm going to explain one example like this. In HTML, we are going to discuss the history of the HTML and what are the header tags, what are the formatted tags, paragraph tags, what are the special characters it will take, what are the image tags, the anchor tags, and what is the background colors and images, how we are going to use with this HTMLs, and how to develop the form, and media tags like how to play the audio files, video files, and some of the new tags. What a new tags was introduced in the HTML5. HTML5 is the latest version in the HTML. So there are some new tags was introduced in the HTML5. We are going to discuss those: drag and drops, videos, canvas, geolocations. Those kind of tags we are going to discuss in the HTML. Coming to the CSS, the latest version of CSS is CSS3. We are purely focusing on the CSS3. In CSS, what is the stylings, how to add the backgrounds, how to change the text, how to change the fonts, how to change the colors, how to designing the tables, like margining, padding, these kind of stuffs we are going to discuss in the CSS, like images, opacities, sprites, media types, that we are going to discuss in the CSS. Up to HTML and CSS are purely tags. We are going to write the tags and we are going to help you out. Like how means, for example, here I'm going to write simple HTML page here. New file, Control Shift S. We need to sample.html. Okay, here if I type HTML, these are the basic tags. Here meta tag in header, meta tags will be there. In the body, whatever we are going to write, that we are going to present on the web browser. For example, here I am writing heading H1, welcome to UI Trainer. If you open right click and open in the browser, means we can see this content. Here, not this, we'll open with the browser. Control S. See this, welcome to UI Trainer. Like this, if you want to add some colors to this means, we can give the style tag. That is using CSS. You can add the some coloring to this word. And if you want to more interactive way, if you want to some validations, like if you go for registration fields, whenever you are registering with Gmail, it will, if you enter some fields, it will say that your password is minimum 8 characters length, our password is combination of a numerics and letters. These we are going to validate in the JavaScript. So coming to the JavaScript, we are going to cover, it's like an object-oriented scripting language. JavaScript is an object-oriented scripting language. Here we need to cover the basics of this language. What are the types of JavaScript? What are the data types it is going to support? How to write the for loops, if loops, and how, what are the browsers which is going to support? What is the object model? What is the Windows? What is document object, DOM, document object models? What is the event handlers, methods, properties? Those kind of stuff we are going to discuss in the JavaScript. Here it will take some time. HTML and CSS are very easy, but JavaScript is little bit complicated. We need to focus more on this, because after this jQuery and as well as AngularJS depends on this JavaScript. We need to be more focused on the JavaScript. Next, we are going to cover the jQuery. What are the jQuery basics? How to write, what is the syntax? The syntax is different from this. Here basics means what type of data types it will support, strings, numbers, booleans, objects, these kind of stuff. And how these selectors will work in the jQuery, CSS selectors, HTML selectors, and how to manipulate the DOM objects, how to transverse the DOM objects, how to apply the CSS methods in the jQuery, manipulations, event handlings, effects means graphics, like how to show some content, how to hide some content, how to toggle some content, fade in, fade out. These are how to develop some kind of job graphics. Here, before going to the jQuery Ajax or JSON, I will talk about what is Ajax and how it will work, how the Ajax request will go to the backend and it will get the results. Those kind of details we'll discuss. And what is JSON also we are going to discuss prior to that. Then we will merge with how jQuery will work with Ajax, how jQuery will work with JSON. We are going to see some of the examples. And before starting the AngularJS, because I will teach you about the Bootstrap, because AngularJS is using the Bootstrap. So before starting the AngularJS, I'm going to teach you about the Bootstrap, how the Bootstrap is designed, how the cells and grids are working here, how the headers and panels we are going to discuss. There are some predefined API, because the Bootstrap means it was developed by the Twitter and then it is given to the open source community, that is called W3C community. So here we are going to discuss these Bootstrap plugins and those kind of stuff. Next major thing, AngularJS. Okay, before coming to the AngularJS, you must know about this HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and as well as Bootstrap, because AngularJS also depends, it is using Bootstrap. How this AngularJS, what are the basics, what is the MVC design pattern, how this MVC design pattern was implemented in the AngularJS, what are the controllers, what are the modules, what are the services, and okay, views, expressions, filters, scopes, Angular forms, and also there are the some promises. Promises is the one of the technology that we are going to deal with RESTful Web Services. And also AngularJS, it was added one more beautiful feature that is called testability. Currently we can't write any test cases for existing JavaScript functionalities. If you write any JavaScript, we can't test it. If you want to test it, you have to open in the browser and see the results. Like in Java, unit test cases, we can write it. Like this, in UI side, means client side, we can't write it. So that was what AngularJS is taken into the picture, so we can write the test cases for front-end controllers and services and views also. That was the one of the beautiful features that was taken by the AngularJS. Okay, almost this will be there. Total this, it will take 20 to 25 hours of time. Okay, this is my course content, or we can say it is a curriculum. So I'm going to cover these technologies. It will take 20 to 25 hours. Okay, if you are coming from the Java background, there are some editors are available to develop these applications. If you are coming from the Java development, we can use Eclipse. If you are coming from the .NET background, we can go for Visual Studio. Even Java and C, they can use with Eclipse. But overall don't know about the Java, .NET or anything, we can go for text editor that is called Sublime Text. This is the one of the editor that is called Sublime Text. Who are familiar with the Java, go with Eclipse. Java or C, they will go with Eclipse. That is my suggestion. Who are not familiar with this Java or C++, they are new to this UI technologies, means then go with the Sublime Text. But I will tell you that how to install these editors and all those stuff. But this is my course content and this is my style. Every day we are going to take 1 hour class. Within this 1 hour, like here you can see this, these are my sample projects. First we are going to discuss about this, what is this tag, and then we are going to develop an example like this and we'll show it at the results at the same time. This is my style. If you guys have any questions or do you require any more topics or any more anything, just please let me know. Anyway, if you required any topics or anything, if you need any more concepts, also you can discuss with me. That I will not stop you at any point. Ravi, are you saying something? But we are not able to hear your voice. Or you can, if you have any questions, you can type in the chat also. Ravi. Generally, if anyone, as per market, I will tell you one more thing also. Nowadays, as per the market, AngularJS is the huge market for this getting the jobs in the US side. AngularJS with these three technologies, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Bootstrap, and you must know about the AngularJS. And also this Ajax and JS. That is also I'm going to cover this. Okay, but jQuery nowadays we are not getting any openings, but still why I'm included this jQuery in our training means it was using in so many legacy projects. AngularJS was popular from last 2 years, but prior to that most of the projects, 90% to 95% of projects, they are used the jQuery. But if you selected for the any legacy projects, existing projects, they must have the jQuery. That's why I'm going to teach you the jQuery and as well as AngularJS. If anyone starting from the scratch or any new projects, definitely they will be there AngularJS. But is in the old or legacy projects, you may get the jQuery. That's why I'm going to cover the jQuery also in this training. Okay, do you guys have any doubts or any questions or any clarifications? Please ask me that. I will answer those questions. If anybody having any questions or any clarifications. Okay, then if you don't have anything,
Vimal? Just stop. Vimal, are you there? Vishnu? Speak once.
Yeah, I'm here. I wanted to ask whether these 20 to 25 sessions will be enough to complete the whole UI.
Yeah, it will be enough, more than enough. I'm teaching from the so many batches, it's more than enough. It will not take not more than 25 classes, maximum 25 to 27. That's it. 25 is the max you can take it. It is more than enough because it is not okay. Purely not a programming. It is only tags kind of stuff. Here you can see this HTML example.
Yeah.
Yes. It is not a language. JavaScript is little bit complicated, but as per that, that is also not purely language. It is a scripting language. More or like a tags. That's why here we don't require that much of time, but you need to be practiced more things.
Okay.
I will tell the, all the classes and all the trainings and examples, PDFs I will provide you that. But it is more enough for the UI side. As for up to now, whatever we cover, that's enough.
Alright, sir.
Okay. Vishnu, you?
Vishnu, Ravi, please type in chat box any doubts, queries. Vishnu? Vishnu, are you able to hear your voice?
Okay, not a problem. Okay, please all, please touch with Prakash. He will tell you the timings and all those steps.
Okay, sure. Okay.
Okay, thank you guys.
Okay, thank you.